Alright everyone, this is Banu again. I am back with my next video tutorial. This time on something different from what I have been teaching in the past few weeks. Earlier I have been teaching on how to solve design aptitude, nonverbal and ability questions. As you know, I hope that those videos are helping you a lot. And this one is particularly about sketching, because I had received a few queries and also some requests from students, some of you, that I should talk about the sketching level that is needed for CEED and UCEED and other exams. So in this video, in this particular video, I am going to cover about what is the sketching level that is adequate or sufficient for from the exam point of view, not from design, design career perspective. This is just from exam point of view, especially the CEED and UCEED exams, design exams. And it doesn't mean that you have to have only this much level, only because since the time is crucial now, many of you would be having some semester exams or also board exams, and it is absolutely difficult to maintain both the tracks, timetable for both these exams as well as the your board and other exams. So time is very crucial right now, and you should understand which part, how much sketching practice is sufficient, so that you will be able to crack the exam. So that's the whole intention of this video. So I am back, I am Banu here again, the person behind Stuffylook blog. I hope you have gone through Stuffylook blog. So let's go ahead. I will be flashing some set of images I have taken from my image, I mean internet. I have also given credits to them in the bottom with the hyperlinks, and those images I will speak whether that much level is required or not. So that based on that, you must be getting some idea of how much level or what exactly you need to prepare for the exam, right? So let's go ahead, let's start with the images. It will be fun. So alright, so you know this, right? This is the famous Mona Lisa image from Italy, if I am not wrong. So what do you think? This is too much, I know, this is too much to ask, but yes, whether you need this much sketching level or kind of art level? No, absolutely no, right? So I hope this is very clear. Let me take some pen. So next, let us see something like this. Absolutely no, right? So this is like a kind of artistic level, very high level, and you actually doesn't need this level. Even if you are artistic, you are good in that. Actually, you don't need to be this much level. Even if you are good in that, save for now. Use the time appropriately for something called design practice rather than simple sketching or color painting and all. Something similar. This is another example where there is an abstract painting, if I am not wrong. So do you need this again? The question is, do you want to play with colors? No. So you don't want to spend your time, invest your time or waste your time coloring images, I mean working on paintings, colors and all. That's because for your exam, especially for CEED and UCEED, most of it, assure you that 90 to 90% of the time, most of it you only be using pencil or pen or something like that, based on the medium you use. Okay, only this is sufficient, and the design questions you are going to attempt are going to be plain, that I am going to show. So you don't have to worry about colors, you don't have to really try to be artistic during the exam. Of course, this kind of works might help you for the portfolio, especially for the MDS, but save that for now, because your portfolio is way ahead. I mean, you have plenty of time, like I have already covered in many of my videos. You don't want to worry about portfolio right now. Okay, so you better not work on colors. So that's my intention. Let me take different color. Yeah, okay, so that's it. So no colors, no coloring, no paints and thing. So simply work on, you know, pencil, pen and all, so that you will have maximum, you know, exposure to the questions being asked. So that's the main intention. So let's move next. Something like this, something like concentrated eyes and you know, eyelids and this thing. You need this? Again, absolutely no. Okay, so if you have seen the past previous questions of seed, UCD and all, you know, you can clearly understand, you can clearly realize that there are no specific questions on, you know, this kind of you know, futures, asking for something called futures of humans or animals, or even animal humans also. If you see, there are no specific questions on that, especially when, apart from given a situation like for example, you know, that could be a comic strip, or that could be animation, or that could be, you know, including the and characters and all. So only those kind of questions needs you to draw these humans or animals. But you know, mostly you don't need this, the futures drawing, all this. So don't spend on this time on this. I know it will be interesting to draw all these things, it will be interesting to show your skills and all, but you know, just for the time being, save the time and move on, and you know, prepare for what is exactly needed. So no such practice, right? So that's my suggestion. That's what I would suggest anyone if they come to me. What about this? A beautiful girl, right? So yeah, no humans, like I said, no portraits, to be specific. Don't, you know, waste your time looking on portraits. Fine. And what about this? So this is kind of like, maybe this is covering, I mean, meeting some scenario, like question ask someone to show the person reading in a candlelight or something like that. Maybe this kind of question, image will suit, but the way the you know, the person has drawn here, they could have been better. It could have been better, right? So I mean, especially with the size, you know, the way the legs are drawn, you know, these curves and all, you know, it could have been better, including the line. You know, you can see, I take different color, it's not visible here, you can see the line, you know, thickness. I mean, how I would say it is not good. You could do better than this. I will show what better means. So both these questions, these images, no. Okay, so absolutely not like this. This beautiful girl, no, don't spend time on this. What about this? It's something on something called, you know, product design, I would say. It's a sketch of showing how a product, especially this bottle, will look like. So what I would say, yes, so you can go with this kind of practice, especially for MDS, if not for BDS. For MDS, you might be needing this kind of you know, product design sketches. This will also help for portfolio. Okay, so something like this, like assume you have created one, you have imagined and come up with a design of a product. So it's good if you put something like this. You even if you see the sketch level, you know, the sketching, right? It's not too much. I mean, you know, don't see overly shaded thing or glossy things on the surface. It's very simple, right? So I what I would recommend is just, you know, this much level is actually sufficient. I have taken this from this particular reference. So this particular reference is, I mean, this particular you know, what you call, level is actually good. So considering the time which you will be given, the time constraint, because you cannot take too much time on this. You have some constraint like 30 minutes, 50 minutes, 20 minutes, right? So based on the time and based on the question given, okay, so you need to, you know, come up with, you need to understand what level of sketching is sufficient. And mostly, if you see, this kind of plain sketches are most suited enough to communicate what you are trying to say, right? So yes, this is yes. Okay, let's move. What about this? Again, some product of kitchen, I guess. Yes, so this is also looking simple in the sense like it doesn't have much work, much details given, but simple kind of rough, you know, sketch, and it is communicating the required things or the required criteria very well. So yes, right. So what about this? I know many of you are very much interested into you know, drawing you know, this kind of racing cars and you know, sports cars and all. But frankly speaking, according to my experience, you know, you don't actually need this kind of practice, at least up to the exam. Maybe you can put this in portfolio, but no, not for the exam point of view. If you see CEAT and UCEAT previous papers, absolutely you won't see any of such questions coming in exam, right? So mostly it will be situation based questions only, not you know, some kind of what you call the concept kind of questions, right? So absolutely don't waste your time, right? So your time is going to be very crucial right now, so don't waste your time on this. This is going to take time. Of course it will prove that you are good at sketching and your skills, but you know, save that for future. Let's not use time for these things. Instead you can go for that plain sketching, like the and design based sketches, the sketches that would solve some designs, and what else, the you know, part A part of your exam, because it is a part A is also going to be important, right? So you need to be very careful, and you need to be, you know, kind of what you call you know, selective in choosing what kind of sketches you are doing right now, right? Let's move on. What about this? So yeah, this is an indoor image, like something like we can say that as perspective image or something like that, right? So my catch will be yes. I mean, I would say go with this kind of situations, because this is actually demonstrating some situation, right? So maybe the question comes like draw. If you have seen UCEAT paper 2020, there is a situation we have to draw the laptop down, right? So something like this. This is also something like this. And if you start, if you practice these kind of sketches, you know what happens. You will be understanding how to, you know, the perspective, what perspective you have to maintain, how to orient the objects, you know, proportion of the objects, and the shadings also, how much the shading is level. You know, this the painter here. I mean the one who did the sketch here. You know, it's like, even though they kind of showed as rough, but still, you know, viewing at this, it is looking very, you know, appropriate, in the sense like everything is in proper shape, including the shades. So yes, you can go with this kind of sketches for the exam. Of course you can take care of these shades with better in a proper way, though they have shown here roughly. But otherwise the other things like the perspective, the image positions and all, yes, you can practice this kind of question. So I think I went back. Yeah, what about this? Yes, this is also demonstrating another situation. But the thing is, you know, if you see the, you know, the one who has sketched here, you know, they didn't you know, minded much about the straightness of the lines, if you can see. Although it's okay, but still, if you can properly practice the straight lines and all, you know, you don't have to you know, using ruler scales and all, and other geometrical shape, geometrical objects are not recommended during exam, right? So you must have heard all this. So you know, this kind of using a scale, ruler and all, don't prefer that. Actually it's not a good one. Like what the expectation would be, like a designer needs to draw lines, curves and all, you know, in a free handedly. Of course I'm not designer, so I'm not able to draw here, but yes, you can do that, right? So like something you can practice every day before you start sketching, every day or weekly whenever you are taking up these questions, you know, start with something like, you know, something like this. Draw like this so that you will practice straight lines, okay? And then after that, this is what I typically do. Like you know, if I am drawing circles, you know, my bad, I'm not using pencil, so maybe it's not coming properly, but yeah, I would do this kind of practice. you know, every day. It will take hardly 5 minutes, and also ellipses, different shapes. Okay, parallel, you know, I will try to draw parallelly all these things, and of course the zigzags or splines also, right? So this kind of helps you, you know, maintain the parallelness of lines, you know, right? So I hope you got this. Sorry. Yeah, so this is what I do, straight lines and all these things. You can practice. So this actually, the attempt here, the person who had drawn here is actually good, but if they had taken care of the straightness of these lines, it would have been, you know, it would I would say it would be awesome, right? So it will fetch let's say 10 out of 10. Right now I can say I would give only 8 or 9 out of 10 or something like that, right? So just my perspective. So yes, this kind of simple sketches where perspective and all is meeting, and if the lines are drawn with care in the given time, it will bring you a good score in the exam. Fine. Something related to the previous one, where again the lines somewhat straight, if not properly, but yes, some of the lines are straight and the shades are also appropriate, right? So yes, you can take this up. You can go with this level of sketching, right? And a few more examples, you know, objects. Start with daily practice, I mean daily objects, like something, things which are around you. Imagine them and draw them in, if possible, in different directions. If the chair, if you can see, if this is a view, maybe you can assume you are viewing from this side and you can draw the same thing here. So that kind of practice also you can do. And also objects like daily used objects and all small objects, quickly you can practice them, so that it will help you understand how to draw and all, like and other, also the products which they have shown. So yes, you can go with this kind of practice. You know, if you Google it, go to Google, you will find plenty of objects and all, plenty of sketches, including indoor, outdoor perspectives and all. You can just watch, observe them for for at least take one image and observe for at least 5 to 10 minutes, like how they have drawn it. Like if you see this, I will observe how much curve they have given, how much amount of detailing they have given, and the design and the turn, how they have shown the turn and all. Right, so if you take any small, even small one, you can easily see, like if you see the shading here, right, you can, I hope you are able to see this, the glass visibility and all, how they have given. So go through images, it is a good practice. Go through the images already available, either in Google images, you know, plenty of places, or in Pinterest, another good source. So these two. And in fact, Insta and all are there, but Insta and all might divert you from, going from to some other place, or, you know, keep watching others. So yeah, usually don't prefer that. Pinterest is good source, or Google Images is absolutely fine. So if you search that, you will find plenty of these images. Just observe them for, for a few minutes, and you will understand what is the perspective, how to draw and all. So you will be learning by observing. So that is very important. As a designer, you need to have that skill, learning by observing, observation and skills, right? So yes, so that's why I have included these images here. Next, what about this? You know, there might be some questions where you will be asked to show the glass, transparency of the glass or something like that. Yes, you have to draw that, but not to that level. This is kind of a higher level, I would say. Maybe it is also not feasible to draw during the exam, so may not be required. This much level is not required. If you are able to draw in within the stipulated time, and if you are able to draw this, yes, you can draw. But if you are like me, just average or above average, and not expert level, and you don't have to struggle to reach to this level right now. You don't want this level. I mean, the way this kind of textures and all has been shown, right? So actually, basically, you don't need this level. in case if you are what you call this coaching centers are guiding you to you know, take up these kind of sketches and all. Actually, I am not sure, but according to me, frankly speaking, probably you don't need this level right now. Maybe it is helpful for portfolio. Like again, I have told you can take a portfolio later, but right now for the exam point of view, because you have only, if I'm not sure, whenever you have, you might be having only 2 or 3 months, right? Hardly, and you will be having other commitments also. So don't spend time on this kind of things. Okay, instead, yeah, what about this? This is kind of solution given, shared by one of my previous student, my close friend also, in the year 2013. Okay, this is kind of little lower in level. Maybe we could have, she could have drawn better, right? Maybe this can be, this could have drawn better. So yeah, especially the curves and all the shades, little better would have been better. I mean, little bit details, I would say, would have been better, but not definitely not to this extent. The same person has shared this is somewhat okay, right? So this is somewhat okay. If there was water inside it, maybe would have understood how the person is able to visualize this. But yeah, not as good as what we are required. So kind of this, the image is blurred here, unfortunately. But if you see, yes, this is kind of good. This is kind of midway between the very good and kind of you know, average, right? So this is somewhat good. You can try this kind of practice, textures especially, right? So yeah. And again, these are all, again, this is blurred, I am sorry. Unfortunately, I have no old images only. So yeah, these are blurred, but if you see how they have drawn it, so it makes us believe that the curves and all, the shades and all, even the texture on the surface, so the skin level and all. So yeah, this is actually good. This is little too much, but yes, good. You can see the shades and all they have given, right? So this is good. Actually, you can go to this level. What about this? Another person shared, I think, in 2014 or 13, I guess, some 6-7 years ago. And this is actually for a question, see the previous question. Actually, this is good, really good. If you see, it's kind of simple, I would say. Not much details are there, but not specifically on much on. But if you see the image particularly, you know, everything is proper. Even the apple, the banana shown here, you know, it has the all the elements being shown, the shading and all. This is, I would say, I would go full marks for this. So this is absolutely yes, you can practice to this kind of level objects, like drawing in something like this. Okay, so I hope this is clear. And yes, so if you see, we have you know, in a previous paper, so I always recommend everyone to, you know, go through previous paper and understand what are the question types being asked, what is happening. Okay, so I always recommend this to just understand what is the questions being asked, and especially the requirements. If you see here, given the character, so and so, do the so and so, and evaluation criteria will be given, ability to keep the character consistent, expression and body gesture of the character, final line quality and finish. So you have to specifically take care of these specific requirements and evaluation criteria based on which you have to attempt the answer. So instead of plainly sketching something or drawing every time object sketches, especially those cars and portraits, you know, I recommend you to take up these kind of questions, some scenarios, and try if you can answer them, so that it will really help you understand really whether you are meeting the requirements, you are designing something, or you are drawing something according to their expectation. I have been getting solutions for this. Many people share with me for reviews, so I see the kind of mistakes they do despite they are very good at sketching, right? Because they miss the criteria, they miss the evaluation features. So that is what I wanted to say. We need to be very careful given the question. So go through the previous question. That's and also attempt some questions which are equivalent to the previous questions. I have shared plenty of examples in the blog also you can use. So these are the examples. I mean, these are the solutions I have given already in the blog for the previous papers. Based on the requirement, based on what they have asked, you can cross check if you want with the question and see if I am meeting the requirement. So why I have shown here is you can see of course I have drawn this on my tab iPad, but the idea here is you can see the line quality, the shades. If you see, I haven't given too much of shades here. Basically it is not required because we have only 20 or 30 minutes, and if I sit and keep giving shades, I might not be able to answer the remaining requirements. So the first thing I would do is I would first complete the outline of the image, and then if there is time I will come back and give little shades and all, right? So this one particular one question, if you see the person, the lady here, I have drawn very simple, especially minding whatever the features have shown here, whatever the features shown here, including the fatness of her. So I tried to replicate here and show the fatness and features, including the shades and all, the same one. And even the the fish basket shown here are exactly trying to replicate here. So that's what I tried here. So I don't want to show other things like backgrounds and all. So that's it. I mean, we don't have to worry much about what is not given. We have to worry about what is actually given. That is nothing but the requirements and the evaluation criteria. Right? I hope this is clear. So something, another question from C2020 is on drawing and the bottom part of this particular grinder mixer, given the top portion, maintaining the same perspective, I have solved this. You can see the shades and all. There's not much shading at all I have given, but if you observe, if you just view this, you will get the perception of a mixer, viewing a mixer, right? So I think this much is sufficient, and if you have time, you can go ahead and do kind of details or what you call decorations to this, right? So that's it. So another thing, this is from UCID. If you see another scenario they have given, and for that scenario, the solution that I have given here is this one, and I have tried to maintain the same perspective view and everything based on the question requirement. Maybe I might have done some fault here because, like I have said, I am not good at sketching. But yes, what I'm trying to show is you can see the texture levels and all, I mean the shades and all. This much is sufficient. We don't have to worry much about giving so much details. So yeah, I hope this is clear. So I hope the examples I have shown, right, the comparisons I have done, and especially the suggestions of not taking something which is not actually required for your exams, right? So is what I wanted to say. Even this is not required, right? So yes, I think this is clear. So I think you'll be able to realize what sketching level is required and what is not required, what you should be taking up, what you should be skipping until the exam, at least until the exam, right? So that's it. Banu here again. I hope you found this helpful, and yeah, let's catch up with another video some other time. Bye bye.